This is the Crescent Dunes Solar Energy Project, located here in Tonopah, Nevada. This project, which opened back in 2015, had originally planned to power more than 75,000 Nevada homes and meet the state's rising demand for electricity. But today, the project has faced a number of different challenges, and even filed for bankruptcy back in 2020. Therefore, why was this project such a failure? And what does the future hold for this $1 billion facility? To answer this, we need to go back to 2011, when construction began on the project. This solar farm was being developed by a company called Tonopah Solar Energy, which was known for developing large-scale solar farms. The original plan for the project was to create a large-scale solar energy plant that would be able to produce electricity for up to 75,000 homes throughout the state, and meet the rising demand for electricity throughout Nevada. The development intended on using a new form of solar technology, with 10,000 large mirrors that would reflect the sun's energy to generate power. The vision for the project was strong, and it received a $700 million loan from the U.S. Department of Energy to cover the development and construction costs over the next few years. This loan guarantee was the largest of its kind given by the U.S. government back in 2011, and placed a large amount of confidence in the future success of the project. In addition to the loan guarantee, the company also secured further funding from private investors and venture capital firms to support the $1 billion development cost of the project. This project was also unique because of the new technology it intended on using. While traditional solar energy plants convert the sun's rays directly into energy, this project planned to use a new form of solar technology that could produce energy more efficiently and planned to operate 24 hours a day. This new technology would use a vast array of mirrors instead of solar panels, which would concentrate sunlight onto a single point. This would then be used to heat molten salt located here in this large storage tank. By using this salt, steam could be created from the heat, which would then be used to drive turbines to produce electricity. As these diagrams show, the design was far from simple, and would operate completely differently than traditional solar farms. The complicated aspects of this untraditional design would turn out to be one of the largest downsides of this project, and would ultimately lead to its failure in the years afterward. Most of these challenges began back in 2013, after construction began on the project. One of the main issues was the technical flaws with the project's design. It was found that engineers had not taken into account the shifts in temperature that occur throughout Nevada, and the extreme temperatures during summer months throughout the state. This resulted in a number of major problems with the facility, including mirrors melting, tower temperatures too low to produce energy, and mechanical parts failing due to the extreme heat. Additionally, the project encountered significant delays due to the complexity of constructing and maintaining the 10,000 heliosat mirrors. These mirrors had to be assembled and calibrated in order to ensure they would work correctly. This process was time-consuming and difficult, which only slowed down the construction process. The complexity of using a new form of solar technology turned out to be one of the key downsides of this project, and these issues came into play once the plant began operation. At the time of development, it was believed that by using a new form of solar technology, electricity could be produced more efficiently and at a higher quantity. The plant was designed to generate electricity 24 hours a day, even during cloudy or unfavorable conditions, all thanks to the energy stored in the molten salt. And while there were strong advantages to this technology, once the plant began operation, the issues became widespread. The first challenge was in the complexity of the system, as it was the first of its kind in the United States. In 2016, just 1 year into the plant's operation, a leak in the molten salt tank caused the plant to shut down for an entire year. It then reopened in July of 2017, once the issue was resolved. But the problems didn't stop there. In 2019, NV Energy, which was the project's sole customer, terminated its contract with the solar farm due to a variety of issues with the technology it was using. Reports have stated that the contract was ultimately terminated due to the project being over budget and the facility not being able to produce the amount of energy that was originally expected. This was, of course, due to the technical flaws with the project's design. It also turns out that this type of solar energy generation was much more expensive than traditional solar farms. While the Crescent Dunes Solar Energy Project was costing NV Energy roughly $135 per megawatt hour, traditional solar farms were charging less than $30. And while the argument can be made that the Crescent Dunes facility was operating 24 hours a day and producing more energy, when it came to the cost, it didn't make a lot of sense to continue operating the plant. Nevertheless, the contract was ultimately terminated, and production was brought to a halt. This then resulted in the plant not generating any electricity for more than 2 years, as there was no customer to purchase it. And while the technical flaws of the project's design were a key cause of its major challenges throughout the past few years, the financial state of the company, Tonopah Solar Energy, was ultimately the key cause behind the project's failure. Due to no income from the facility for nearly 2 years, the company filed for bankruptcy in July of 2020. Reports have stated that at the time of bankruptcy, the company still owed more than $400 million to the U.S. Department of Energy for the loan it received to construct the project. With no sufficient income, repaying this loan may prove to be a long-term problem for the company to solve. At the time of bankruptcy, the company's debts on the project exceeded $400 million, and to this day, it's still unclear as to how much of this still needs to be repaid. After years of delays, problems, and bankruptcies, this project seemed to have no future. With insufficient technology and a bankrupt company, the future of the Crescent Dunes Solar Energy Project did not look strong. But all of this took a drastic change in 2021. A report from the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation stated that the project had resumed full operation and electricity production in July of 2021. This was due to the high demand for electricity throughout the state. Reports have stated that since the plant was not in operation for such a long period of time, most of the technological issues were able to be solved, and that the plant is functioning properly today. The failure of the Crescent Dunes Solar Energy Project is an important lesson in the challenges and risks associated with renewable energy technology. With issues ranging from the complexity of the design to the cost of development, all of this highlights the need for careful planning and oversight when undertaking new types of renewable energy projects. Today, this facility is in full operation, and solar energy continues to expand across the state of Nevada. While this project went through a number of challenges during development, today it's proving to be extremely beneficial for the state, with electricity demand continuing to increase. But for now, it seems that this project is back on track, and is headed for a successful future ahead. Thank you for watching, and please consider subscribing if you enjoyed the video.